guys. So we're looking at section 9.7. Our goal today is to be able to verify identities, simplify trigonometric expressions, and solve trig equations. We've already done the solve trig equations, so we won't get into that unless we have time. But the part about verifying identities and simplifying trigonometric expressions, that's our main goal. In order to be able to do these two things, you have to understand the fundamental trig identities. We have the reciprocal identities. These are the ones that you probably already know. We know cosecant is 1 over y, so therefore we know cosecant is 1 over sine. Secant is 1 over x, so therefore it's 1 over cosine. Cotangent's 1 over tangent. A lot of times people want to use 1 over tangent for cotangent, but really the name we're going to use most of the time for cotangent is cosine over sine. The reason that works is because cotangent is x over y, and we already know that x is equal to cosine theta on the unit circle, and y is equal to sine theta on the unit circle. These Pythagorean identities are very helpful to know. Here's the reason that they work. Let's say I have an angle theta here. Well, if this is a right triangle, I know a squared plus b squared has to equal c squared. Instead of using a, b, and c, I have x, y, and r. So I know x squared plus y squared has to equal c squared, which is 1. But what's another name for x? So I know cosine theta squared plus sine theta squared is equal to 1. This is the way we write that. We just typically put the sine first. It's just kind of the way that mathematicians decided to do it. So sine squared theta plus cosine squared theta is 1. Now, what if I take this and I divide it by x squared? What's x squared over x squared? What's y over x? So that's tangent squared then. And what's 1 over x? Secant. See how it's really just this identity? 1 plus tangent squared equals secant squared. You will not have to memorize all of these for this year, but next year you will. And so I'm just showing you a way that you can figure this out without really having to memorize it. You can figure it out on your own. What else could I divide this by instead of x squared? Y squared. So watch if I divide each term by y squared. What's x over y? X over y is cotangent, so that's cotangent squared. What's y squared over y squared? And then what's 1 over y? So see how it's really just giving us this Pythagorean identity. So I always use this to develop those Pythagorean identities when I have to memorize them. The cofunction identities. This is something you probably noticed on the unit circle. For example, if I have the unit circle and I have this point and this point, the x value here is the same as the y value here. So what I'm talking about is when I have pi over 6 versus when I have pi over 3. Do you guys know what pi over 6 is in degrees? And what's pi over 3 in degrees? What do they add up to be? So whenever those angles add up to be 90 or pi over 2, then if I do 90 minus 30, that's the same as the cosine of 60. All right? Let's come down here and let's look at this. If I'm doing this problem, I can just do it as written. But I would have to get a common denominator. So I'd multiply this by 3 over 3. So this would be 3 pi over 6. This would be multiplied by 2 over 2, 2 pi over 6. So what does that give me? Pi over 6. What is the cosine of pi over 6? Radical 3 over 2 is the cosine of pi over 6. So I could do the problem that way. But I could also use this cofunction identity. If I have the cosine, let's go to this one, the cosine of pi over 2 minus theta, that should be the same thing as the sine of theta. And you guys should know then that if I have the sine of pi over 3, what's that going to be? Sine of 60 degrees, guys. So see how that's just another way I could have done the problem is by using this co-function identity. Right? So if I see the cosine of pi over 2 minus pi over 3, instead of actually figuring it out, I can just say, oh, that's the same as the sine of just pi over 3. Okay? All those work. Negative angle identities. This is saying that the sine of negative theta is the same as negative sine theta. The cosine of negative theta is the same as cosine theta. Now, what does this mean? Well, it means this, like this problem here. If I'm doing the sine of negative 45 degrees, that means instead of going up, I'm going down. For 45 degree reference, we've got 1, 1, radical 2, this is a negative. What is the sine of negative 45 degrees? This answer is negative radical 2 over 2, right? According to this formula, if I do the sine of negative 45, that should be the same thing as the negative, the sine of positive 45. Is that true? What's the sine of 45 degrees? And then put a negative. See how that works? What about this one? Can anybody explain why the cosine of negative theta would be the same as the cosine of positive theta? Why would those be equal to each other? X is positive in those quadrants, isn't it? Okay, and then tangent, we can think of that kind of the same way. In the fourth quadrant, tangent's negative, but in the first quadrant, it's positive. So that's why it works like that. All right, let's do this problem. To do the sine square root of 30, that means to find the sine of 30 and then square it. What is the sine of 30? 1/2, and then we have to square it. What is the cosine of 30? Radical 3 over 2, and then we have to square it. What is 1 squared over 2 squared? 1/4. What's radical 3 squared? Over 2 squared. What does that give us? Do you see how the angle theta is the same here? And this is sine squared theta plus cosine squared theta. If I were taking the ACTs, if I knew this identity, do you see how I would just automatically know it's 1 instead of having to take all that time to figure it out? These will save you time. And that's what it's all about, is like saving yourself time. Okay, so let's look at how we can verify these expressions now. These are almost like proofs from geometry. Some of you right now are not fans of that. What I'm trying to do is I'm trying to prove that this is the same thing as that. What this means is I only work on one side of the equation. I want to choose which side to work with. You want to work on the most complicated side. It's much easier to make this simplified than it is to make that look like that. So I'm going to take this side and I'm going to find some other names. One of the most common things we do is we change to sine theta and cosine theta. Anything I have, I want to rewrite it as sine theta or cosine theta. So if I have secant squared x, I'm going to look at secant. Secant is 1 over cosine. So I'm going to rewrite this secant squared x as 1 over cosine squared x. 1 plus cotangent squared x. I have to look back at my paper. What is 1 plus cotangent squared x? Cosecant squared x. So I'm going to make the denominator now cosecant squared x. But I just said I want to change everything to sine and cosine. This is already cosine, but that one's not. So what is another name for cosecant? 1 over sine. So now I'm going to change this into 1 over sine squared. If I have 1 divided by cosine squared, divided by 1 divided by sine squared. I want to get rid of this denominator, so I'm going to multiply by sine squared on bottom and sine squared on top. These now cancel. So what do I get in the numerator then? Just what? Sine squared over cosine squared. Do you see that? 1 times sine squared is sine squared over cosine squared. What's another name for sine over cosine? Okay, tangent. So therefore we're going to have equals tangent squared, and we are finished. So again, every problem, if we can change to sine and cosine, that's good. The reason that's good is because sine over cosine is tangent. Cosine over sine is cotangent. And then we can usually get to what we need. Any questions on what I did there? Okay. Let's go to the second one now. What would I do if I have two fractions? What do I always want to do? Get a what? Common denominator. So if I have a denominator of cosine and sine, I want to multiply this one by sine x over sine x. I want to multiply this one by cosine x over cosine x. What is sine times cosecant? If sine is y and cosecant is 1 over y, what is it, Cameron? It's 1. So sine times cosecant is just 1. So I have 1 over sine x cosine x minus, what's cosine times cosine?
Cosine squared.
Cosine squared. I have a common denominator. So now I can just make it 1 minus cosine squared over sine x cosine x. What is 1 minus cosine squared? Well, you may not know right off, but come back over here. 1 minus cosine squared. If I took this over here, I would get 1 minus cosine squared. And what would be left? Sine squared. So 1 minus cosine squared is sine squared. So I'm going to replace this with sine squared. And it's all over. Sine x cosine x. I keep looking at what I'm trying to get. I'm trying to get tangent. What is tangent?
Sine over
cosine. Sine over cosine. So that's what I'm trying to get is sine over cosine. Can you see how sine squared, I can think of it as sine x times sine x. And I'll have over sine x cosine x. What's going to cancel? One of the sine x's. What's sine x over cosine x? Tangent x. We are finished. We verified it. We proved it. All right. Let's take a look at number 3. What do we always do when we have a negative? Yeah, distribute it out. So I have sine squared x plus secant squared x minus tangent squared x plus cosine squared x, and I'm trying to get it to equal 2. What numbers add to be 2?
1 and 1.
1 and 1. I'd love to get 1 and 1 somehow. Even if I can just get 1, 1 for now. Does anybody see how I could get 1, 1? Carter? Anybody see how I can get 1, 1? Shapiro? Yeah, I'm going to move this down here. I'm going to move that cosine squared x so that it's right next to the sine squared x. So I'm going to rearrange things. Sine squared x plus cosine squared x. We just looked at that. What was it?
1
plus secant squared x minus tangent squared x. Let's go look over here. What is secant squared theta minus tangent squared theta going to give me? How convenient. 1 plus 1 is 2. That's what I wanted. Great. Okay? So So be looking for things like sine squared plus cosine squared, because we know that's going to be 1. All right. Number 4. This is the more complicated side because we have, you know, 2 terms. And here we just basically have a product. So what is my first step? What do I want to write cosecant as?
1 over sine.
1 over sine. Minus sine. What do I always want to do when I have both of these and they're separate? Get a common denominator. So I'm going to have to multiply this by sine x over sine x. So now I've got 1 minus sine x times sine x is sine squared x. And I have a common denominator. That's going to stay the same. I'm trying to get multiplication. I don't want to have 2 terms. I want to get rid of 2 terms. I want to make 1 term. So I need to go and see what is 1 minus sine squared. What would 1 minus sine squared be? Cosine squared. So I'm going to replace this with cosine squared. Well, I'm trying to get cosine. I kind of have a cosine because I have cosine times cosine. I'm going to write this as cosine x times cosine x all over sine x. When I do this, only one of these factors is over sine, not both of them. It's just like this, guys. If I'm multiplying 3 times 4 divided by 3, that's 12 divided by 3. What's the answer? 4. Wouldn't it just be 3 over 3, but the 4 is not over the 3? See what I mean with that? This is the same kind of thing. This is cosine times cosine over sine. Only one of those is over the sine. Cosine is by itself, so I have cosine by itself. I wrote that one. What is cosine over sine? Cotangent. And that's what I wanted. So I'm just showing that I got what I wanted. Okay? All right. Let's go down here. Now, this to me is a little bit tougher. It says simplify to a single expression. Now I don't know what I'm trying to get. This part was like a puzzle. I know the answer. I know the big picture. I know what it's supposed to equal. I just got to make the pieces fit. This, I don't know what the answer is. All I know is I have to get a single expression. Right now, I have a quotient. I want to get rid of the quotient. I want to have a single expression. I'm going to go one step at a time. Negative tangent of negative theta. Well, what is tangent of negative theta? Negative tan theta. So I've got this negative. Is this negative for the numerator and denominator, or numerator or denominator? Or. So right now I have a negative, and then I know tangent negative theta is going to be negative tan theta. So if I have negative and negative, what's that going to make it? Positive. So now I have a positive. So I have positive tangent theta. What should I change secant into? 1 over cosine. You got it. What can I change tangent into? Sine over cosine. Oops, that should be theta. So now I have sine theta over cosine theta, all divided by 1 over cosine theta. What do we do? If I'm dividing by 1 divided by cosine, what do I do to get rid of this complex fraction?
Multiply
by cosine theta. Those cancel. And so what would my single expression be? Sine theta. So all of this right here is just the same thing as sine theta. All right? Okay. Let's look at the next one. Sine of pi over 2 minus x. It's a puzzle. We got to see what is that equal to. Sine of pi over 2 minus theta. So what is that going to be equal to? That's sine of pi over 2 minus x. Okay, good. So we're going to have all of this is just going to be cosine x. What do we change secant to? 1 over cosine x. See if you can figure out what that's going to be. Justin? It is. It's cosine squared. We're going to multiply the top and bottom, the numerator, denominator. So we get cosine squared x. That's our single expression. One term squared. All right, let's keep going. Let's have two more. All right, checking out this one. We always first, when we have a couple of terms, we'd like to think of the GCF. So what is it that both of those can have factored out? 2. So I'm going to take out a 2, and I've got secant squared x minus tangent squared x. All right, what about down here? Tangent of negative x. Are you starting to memorize that? Do you know which one that is? That's negative tan x. See, all my angles have to match. That's why I can't keep that with a negative x. I have to have it as a positive x, so it's the same as these. Cosine of negative x. That's just going to be regular cosine, isn't it? Cosine of x.
Wait, why
does
the negative not change?
Because
it's
cosine of negative x, I'm thinking ahead. In the fourth quadrant, cosine is positive. In the first quadrant, it's positive. So therefore, the cosine of a negative angle is the same as the cosine of a positive angle. Or I can look back here. You'll have the sheet. Cosine of negative x is cosine x. All right, so we've got this now. Secant squared x minus tangent squared x. That might be something good. Let's see. Secant squared x minus tangent squared x. Oh, that's great. What is it?
1.
So this can just get replaced with 1. 1 times 2 is just 2. Still trying to get it down to a single expression. Does anybody know what to do? Justin? That's not going to help us as quickly as something else would. What did I say we always want to get everything in terms of?
Cosine and sine.
Cosine and sine. Oh. All right, Karen, what do we do?
Replace tan x with sine x over cosine x.
Yeah. See, that's going to be the best, fastest thing to do. See, there are always different ways of going about this, but do you see how this is a good choice? Because look what's going to happen. Boom, boom. Now, this is really 2 times 1, okay? So I have a 2, and then what's 1 over sine? 1 over sine is cosecant, remember? 1 over sine is cosecant, so I have 1 over sine, and that's going to be cosecant, and so that's what we're going to end up with. Negative cosecant, 2 cosecant x. Can you guys see that? See how we have a negative, so I knew it was negative. 2, I got the 2. 1 over sine is cosecant. And I know at first it seems like I would never think to do this stuff, but you will. Once you do about 5 problems, you'll be like, oh, tangent is sine over cosine. It just kind of starts coming to you. All right, let's look at this one. Sine of pi over 2 minus theta. Do you remember that? Cosine theta, good. And I have a negative, so it's negative cosine theta. Now, secant of negative theta, because secant is the reciprocal of cosine, I just look at cosine of negative theta. Does the sign change? No. So it's not going to change for secant either. So this is just going to be secant theta. Then I have minus sine squared theta. All right, not so great yet. What should we do, though? Tori? I like it. So we're going to have negative cosine theta over 1 over cosine theta. Still got this. All right, any ideas now what to do? Karen? I want to get rid of any complex fractions first. How do I get rid of a complex fraction?
Sean? Yeah, I'm going to multiply by cosine theta here and cosine theta here.
So now these cosine thetas cancel. So I just have a 1 in the bottom. That doesn't even matter. What's cosine times cosine? So now I have negative cosine squared minus sine squared. Getting better. So I took 1, 2, 3 and turned it down to 2. That's a good start. Tori? She's right. Anytime I have a negative on both of these, I want to factor it out. If I just had a negative on one, probably don't need to factor it out. But in this case, it's good because look what I have. Sine squared plus cosine squared. Sine squared plus cosine squared is 1. So we just have negative 1 times 1. So all of that stuff up there is the same thing. It's just negative 1. And we are finished because we have it simplified to a single expression. All right, so on a scale of 1 to 5, with 1 being I am so confused, 5 being I just got this. Give me a number. Hold up your hands. All right, lots of 2s and 3s and 4s. I like the 4s. And guys, that's what I expect, all right? So after you do the worksheet, I'm hoping that you'll all be up to a 5, to where you feel pretty good about it. All right, we're going to stop there.